guys, it's Luke from Luke the Gathering. Thanks for checking out my channel. Today I have an unboxing for you. It's Zendikar Rising, and it is a set booster. Zendikar Rising. About $100 picked this up for. Didn't get a whole lot of Zendikar Rising, so when the new standard comes around, a couple months, Zendikar Rising will be the first set of the Zendikar Rising, Kaldheim, Strixhaven, Forgotten Realms. And so I want to have a good supply of Zendikar Rising for my own collection. I don't know a whole lot about the set at all. I played in one booster draft tournament for Zendikar Rising, but that's my whole experience with Zendikar. Don't really know what to look for. I'm going to have to go look on YouTube for some top cards from Zendikar to kind of familiarize myself with this set. So if I pull something and it's amazing, but I don't get it, that's why. Because I don't know a whole lot about this set. It wasn't there when this set was released. So brand new to me, but excited to open up a set booster box, find out what this is all about. So let's go ahead, let's rip this open right now. All right, so here it is, Zendikar Rising set booster box. Kind of a nice little box here, nice display. I'm gonna probably just totally rip into it. Stick my finger in there and boom. Get all that wrapping off. Guaranteed foil, up to 4 rares. And, ooh, cool, there's a little box topper there, but how do you even get this open? Oh, there we go, that flaps open like so. Alright, wow, look at that. Zendikar Rising set boosters. And this is the first, time they had set boosters for Magic. And we're not going to spend a lot of time on the commons and uncommons. But we'll take a quick look at, for example, we have the art cards that are included. And we're just going to go through. So common, uncommon. We're not going to look too much at those. We're just going to go right to our rare. And we got Confounding Conundrum. Blue enchantment. Ooh, double rare pack. Inscription of Insight. And a foil Royal Eruption. And the copy is what the token is. Ooh, we got a signature art. That is a really nice looking art card, though, if I do say so myself. Planes, I love the land cards in these. They look really, really good. So we have a rare Felidar Retreat. It's an enchantment for white. Turn Timber Ascetic, common. And a Lash Out. Lash Out deals 3 damage to target creature. Nice. So that's it's good for a red deck. You know, those cards from the list, I really don't know what that's all about. Just know that they throw those in every so often. Beautiful art cards, though, here. Featuring the full art of, a lot of the cards, or every card it should be from the set. So we have a River Glide Pathway. And on the back of that, a Lava Glide Pathway. That makes sense. So we can either add red or blue. So that's a dual land type thing. Kind of cool looking. But you get to choose. I mean, it doesn't always give you red and blue. It just gives you one or the other when you get it. Cool picture there. And we have our land, which is our mountain. We're going to go right to our rare, Throne of Makindi. Throne of Makindi. Another rare, Kargan Intimidator. Uncommon, Fearless Fledgling. And plant. Oh, by the way, I didn't order. Darn, I thought I ordered a collector's booster. That's another thing I want to get from Zendikar Rising, a collector's booster. Well, here is that same art card that I got before, except this one does not have the gold signature. The gold signature actually looks really pretty sweet on there. But that's a good looking card. I do like that one. And we do have a foil land for the forest. And rare again, Zagras, Thief of Heartbeats. And a Utility Knife foil. And then Beseech the Queen from the list. Okay, we got a mountain. And we got rare here, Skyclave Relic. And let me know if there's anything great I pull out of this Rabid Bite common foil, because I sure as heck don't know a whole lot about Zendikar Rising. Like I said, I'm not going to spend a lot of time in this video like reading the cards or anything. So, excuse me if I fly past something that might be really good. So, Crawling Barrens. This one you can add just colorless mana and then put 2/+1/+1 counter on Crawling Barrens, and it becomes a creature that's still a land. So a 2/2, and that's a regular card. That's kind of neat. Then Dreadworm common and a Haship Oasis from the list. I feel like we got a good amount of list cards already in here. The Swamp. And another rare, Relic Robber. Where are the mythics at? Squad Commander, so dual rare pack with a common Tajuru, Snarecaster, and a Fabricate. Fabricate from Magic 2010 from the list. Alright. Ooh, look at this. Kind of scary looking. We got a foil mountain. That's nice. I like those foil lands. It looks so good. Here's a rare Wayward Guide Beast. Another rare Tabarak's Hope's Demise. And a Roiling Regrowth foil, and still no mythics. So I'm a little bit like, where are the mythic cards? Are they not in here or what? Ooh, very cool art card there. And here's our mythic, Agadeem's Awakening. So our first mythic, Agadeem's Awakening. Return from your graveyard to the battlefield any number of target creature cards that have a different converted mana cost X or less. Okay. Shepherd of Heroes and a token. So one mythic so far. Looks like another list card in this pack. See what we have. Ooh, okay, Clear Water Pathway. And this is the extended art. And then Murk Water Pathway. Ooh, and we got a foil rare here, Soul Shatter. Along with a rare from the list. And this is a Braid. Very cool. Wow. I don't know. Maybe the Zendikar art cards. I just feel like the Zendikar art cards have looked better to me than some of the other ones I've opened in other set boosters. Maul of the Skyclaves. The rare. And then a common Highborn Vampire for the foil. Still feeling the shortage of mythics, though. Is kind of what I'm feeling like with this box. Lotus Cobra, that's a nice looking card. Here's a mythic, Emiria's Call. It says create 2/4/4 white angel warrior creature tokens with flying. Non-angel creatures you gain control until gain indestructible until the end of your next turn. Hey, that sounds pretty good. And a rare Soul Shatter, and an uncommon foil, Black Bloom Rogue. That's a cool looking piece of art there on that card. I like it. Ooh, see this? More cool looking art. Zendikar's like the art styles that I like. Branch Loft Pathway. So more of these. And we got what, white on the back? Yep. Boulder Loft. Maybe they could have come up with some better names though. Ghoul Draz Mucklord is a common foil. more cool art. And this time we got a foil swamp. And a Felidar Retreat, along with Vastwood Fortification foil, and then a plant to finish that pack off. Alright, more art, of course, in the front. In this pack, we have Skyclave Shade as the rare Seafloor Stalker foil. Oh, I went through the pack the wrong way. Darn it, I was like, that looked weird to me. But we did get a double-sided card, so here we go. Oh, Akiri Fearless Voyager is a rare, and then this was an extended art River Glide Pathway with the Lava Glide Pathway, and I already got this non-rare as well. A Myriad Construct as a rare Expedition Skulker foil. Ooh, looks like another list card right there. Is there anything amazing in the list? I don't even know. Mythic, finally. Ashaya, Soul of the Wild. Seagate Colossus, and a Disenchant. Looks like a textless card. No text. Disenchant. That's kind of cool looking though, right? That's probably the best one from the list, or at least the best looking one. Here, another list. That's a cool Disenchant, though. Got a rare Coral Helm Chronicler. Just a common Resolute Strike. And a Phyrexian Tower. Legendary Land. Hey, this is really nice. That's cool looking. I don't know where that's from, but it looks really nice, and it has the old frame. Alright, let's keep going here. Two rares in this pack. Archpriest of Iona and Confounding Conundrum. And then a regular common Ghastly Gloomhunter. So I'm going to be taking a good look at these cards after this opening, because I don't know a lot about it. Like I said, Bright Climb Pathway. It's a Grim Climb Pathway. But, I mean, these are full of these, like, sort of lands where you can choose one or the other. Oh, my gosh. There go all the packs on the floor. I'm going to pick them up after this pack. Oh, my gosh. Okay, here we go. Rare Master of Winds. Common. Ooh, that's a really cool foil, though. Those red lines coming out of the side. Oblivion's Hunger. So I dropped a few packs on the floor. Let me just let me move this out of the way. I'll open this pack, and then I'm just going to go to the floor and get the rest of the packs. The box just keeled over. It was getting a bit too heavy. Because I have a table right here in front of me. So that's what happened. Okay, Orin Reef Ooze. So we got an ooze. And then a common foil, Subtle Strike. Alright, so I'm actually going to go down here and pick up some of these packs. Oh, I'm on the floor here. Okay, not too many. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, looks like 8 packs fell down. So we just have a few more to go, really. 8 packs, and of course, I don't want to forget, we also have the, there was that box topper. So I want to check out the box topper as well. Cool art card. And Zagras, we got him again. Dauntless Unity is in this pack. And we got this. I don't know which way that art goes. Okay, we have a Yisharn Implacable Earth and a Fissure Wizard. Alright, next up we have a foil and plains and a Swarm Shambler, common Prowling Felidar, the extended looking special art showcase or whatever they call those. The island in this one. Ooh, mythic. Ancient Green Warden. You may play lands from your graveyard. Okay, interesting. Oh, and a rare Inscription of Insight and a Lashweed Lurker from the list. All right, we go all the way to the back here, and it looks like we got another one. Oh, here we go. I thought it was a land, but it's not. It's a Kazandu Mammoth, and there's a land on the other side. But you have this big, giant creature elephant on the other. Ooh, and we got a Legion Angel, and this is a rare foil. So that's really nice to get the rare foil. Just two more packs, and then, of course, we got the box topper. Check that. That's cool. Okay, rare Inscription of Ruin with a Thieving Skydiver and a Seagate Banneret. Here is our final pack. Like I said, I'm going to have to take some time to just look over these cards because these are very unfamiliar to me. We're ending up with a Grackbaw Skyclave Ravager. Ooh, it's like a three-headed Hydra Horror. Blood Beckoning is, and that's it. So, the only last thing I have, I'm checking the packs, because the packs did fall over earlier, and nope, that's it. So here we go, Zendikar Rising Expedition Box Topper. So let's see, what do we got? We got Wooded Foothills. Pay one life, sacrifice Wooded Foothill. Search your library for a mountain or forest card. Put it into the battlefield. It's like a fetch land. So, nice. Well, there you have it. One full set booster box of Zendikar Rising. Like I said, I'm not really familiar with the set. I'm planning to try to get more Zendikar Rising and Kaldheim. I've gotten a ton of Strixhaven. So, I'm not worried about that. But I am missing a lot of these two era of Magic cards for the Standard, and I want to play in Standard when the rotation comes out, so I'm kind of preparing myself by buying a bunch of cards and hopefully learning those as well. Thanks for watching this. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll see you next time.